and direction as he follows God so that the word can spread. And if there's one thing every deacon needs to know, is that the deacon needs to be alert and attentive to keep chaos and confusion down. Because people will naturally complain, and you can't help everybody, and you can't hear every complaint, because if you do, you'll be hearing them all the time. You got to be wise enough and insightful enough to come back and give them a biblical answer. And that's why it says you have to be a person of character. And you got to understand that everything we do, now we have independent positions, but we don't work independent of each other. We work side by side, the pastor and the deacons and the body, and we work with one another to fulfill the will of God and to establish the kingdom of God wherever he leads us. Amen. And so Christ came into this world. Why is it so important? Because he came into this world. He died for the sins of the world. He was buried in our place and he rose on our behalf. And the only way for people to get saved is they got to get saved through the gospel. You don't get saved because you do good. You don't get saved because you join a local church. You got to be born again. And you only get born again through the word of God. And so the deacons frees the pastor so the pastor can be focused and continue to pray and feed the word people the word of God. And somebody might ask, well, what about the pastor's wife? Well, she takes care of the pastor at home, so that he can stay mentally sound, and so that what the deacons do for him in the public, she does for him in private. Amen. Let us stand. I said it's going to be a teaching message. I hope it's been helpful. And I hope we will take heed to the word of God and live it out in our lives. But before we go, we want to extend an invitation because, again, it's the preaching of the gospel that saves souls. And hearing the word of God, you may have heard something that was said that may prompt you or lead you to receive Christ for the first time or to rededicate your life, praise the Lord, and to come forth and give your life to him. You may not have a church home, and you want to make your church this church, a church family, because God wants us to know him, God wants us to grow in him, and God wants us to sow him. But you got to know him for yourself, you got to grow in him, you got to be mature, and then you can share him wherever you go so that lives and souls can be saved. One soul that is lost is one too many. So if you don't know Christ, if you've not accepted him, do come. If you want to rededicate your life, doesn't matter how far you slipped away or how far you got away from him, God stands with open arms to welcome you back home. Or maybe you're here today, you just don't have a church home, and the Spirit is saying to you, this is a place where you can grow, this is a place where you can become what God has already destined for your life. God has a perfect plan and purpose for you, and he's saying, come and be a part of this family. If that's you today, as we lay it in a quick song by Minister Jerome, I'm going to ask that you would come following the direction of the Spirit. Amen.
Lord, prepare me to be a sanctuary.
Amen.
Pure and holy, tried and thanksgiving.
Yes, Lord. Is there another one?
I'll be a living.
If you don't have a church home, want to rededicate your life,
sanctuary.
Become a part of our church family.
Lord,
might need somebody to pray with you, pray for you. If that's you, why don't you come?
Lord, prepare me.
Ask him to prepare you.
To be a sanctuary.
Yes, Lord.
Pure and holy.
Why don't you come?
Tried and true.
Make this your spiritual birthday month.
With thanksgiving.
Yes.
I'll be a living sanctuary.
Amen.
Lord.
Come on, let's give God a hand clap of praise in this house. Amen. Praise the Lord. So thankful to see so many out today in those live streaming. Pray you've been blessed. Let's take the word and eat on it and chew on it until it becomes a living part of our lives. Also, just before we leave, don't forget that Brother Busey, who used to be a member here, passed away on last week. And for those that remember him, he was in his 90s. He was 90 taking care of his mother, who was 111. And he drove to Virginia 5 years ago at the age of 93 by himself, and was driving up until this year when he caught pneumonia and began to go down. But we want to pray for his family. They're going to have the visitation here at 10 o'clock on Thursday, and then the funeral and the homegoing celebration will be at 12. So be in prayer for the Busey family. Also, we want to thank everyone who came out on yesterday at the Christmas Fellowship. It was the first time we tried it at 12, and it wasn't the turnout we normally have, but a lot of people said they didn't know about it, so I apologize if it was not communicated well. So we're going to evaluate and try to make sure we're better at it next year. But it was a good time, and I want to thank God for all the volunteers and for what everyone has done. Also, I want you to be out on Wednesday at our noonday as we continue going through the letter in the book of Ephesians, and asking that you would come out of our noonday Bible study, our 7 o'clock in the evening, and also prayer preceding those. Also, let me say this so you can prepare yourself. At the beginning of January, Lord willing, on the second day, we're going to begin a 21-day fast. So we're asking that all of our members will become a part of fasting as we open up the new year with fasting and praying. Amen. So we're going to be fasting for 21 days. I'll give you a better understanding of what kind of fast it would be. But don't leave the church. And we're going to help you get through this. Amen. But seriously, fasting is something that a lot of people have neglected. And there's power in fasting. And it draws you closer to God. And it draws God closer to you. I'm going to ask that again, that Pastor Holder would close us out. Let's give God a hand clap of praise for him. 40 years of pastoring Clay Street Baptist Church in Shelbyville, Kentucky. We're going to give him a mic. Where's the mic at? Give me that red mic right there, if you will. Next, do you have any information? Minister Ball has an announcement to make.
So next Sunday, the mayor is going to be here at 2 p.m. to meet with our youth. That's grades 8 through 12. He wants to meet with them at the Family Life Center just to have open dialogue with the recent events, and then more so just to open that up as far as our relationship, developing a relationship with our youth and just not with the more tenured members of our congregation. And also, very quickly, if you are interested in supporting our youth who are participating in the Jack and Jill organization, we ask that you would see Kathy, Sister Kathy Corb, if you just raise your hand. So if you're interested in supporting that, we ask that you would see her.
All right, Pastor Holder, I'm going to ask that we will give the mic to him, and then last one of our men would help him come back down, if you will. Amen.
Let us pray. Lord, we thank you for your preached word. Give us a better understanding of what our role should be in your church. Bless Reverend Nelson. Let him live long and preach well. And then, Lord, bless every deacon in this church from the bottom of their feet to the tops of their head. And bless this congregation. Help them to be the people that you're calling for in these last days. In Jesus' name, let your church say amen.
Amen. Thank you, Pastor. Have a great day. Have a great week. God bless you.